Assembly drawing. In this second section of the Drafting Getting Started tutorial, you'll learn how to generate views from an assembly on a drawing sheet. Additionally, you'll learn how to use other generative functionalities. We will go through listed tasks in this section. You can also go back to the first section of the tutorial and learn about part drawings. Opening an assembly. This task will show you how to open the 3D assembly from which you will create views in the drafting workbench, as well as perform other operations. Select File, Open, or click Open in the standard toolbar. The File Selection dialog box appears. Select the assembly to be opened. Gear Reducer underscore GS CAT product document. Link for the related parts can be found in the description. Please keep all files in the same folder. Click Open. The assembly is opened and will remain displayed in the window, whatever views you create from it. Creating a frame and a title block. This task will show you how to insert a frame and a title block in the background of the sheet you defined. Click the drawing window to activate it. If you closed it, you can open a new one using File, New, Drawing Command. For the menu bar, select Edit, Sheet Background to switch to the background. Click Frame and Title Block in the drawing toolbar. The Manage Frame and Title Block dialog box is displayed. Choose a style from the Style of Title Block drop-down list. For the purpose of this exercise, choose Drawing Title Block Sample 1. You can notice that a preview of the frame and title block is displayed in the dialog box. Click the action you want to perform from the list of actions. In this case, click Create. Click OK. Wait while the frame and title block are being created. For the menu bar, select Edit, Working Views to switch back to the working views. Creating views via the wizard. This task will show you how to create a number of views on the sheet you defined, from the 3D assembly you opened. At this step, it will be more convenient if you tile the drawing and the assembly windows horizontally. To do this, click Window, Tile Horizontally from the menu bar. If you performed the part drawing section of the tutorial, you deactivated the view name and scaling factor. They are set by default. You now need to reactivate them so that they are displayed in views. To do this, go to Tools, Options, Mechanical Design, Drafting. Click on the Layout tab and check the View Name and Scaling Factor options. Also, you need to specify what geometrical and dress-up elements should be generated on views. Click on the View tab. Make sure Generate Center Lines is selected and check Generate Axis. Click View Creation Wizard in the Views toolbar. The View Wizard Step 1 of 2 Predefined Configurations dialog box is displayed. Click Configuration 3 using the first angle projection method to create a front, a top and a left view using the ISO standard first angle projection method. Click Next to go to the second step of the wizard. The View Wizard Step 2 of 2 Arranging the Configuration dialog box is now displayed with a new set of view buttons. Simply click Finish to validate and exit the dialog box. Now, in the assembly window, select the slow speed sub-assembly from the specification tree. Then, click on the desired plane on the 3D assembly to define the reference plane. On the sheet, a blue knob appears, as well as three green frames containing a preview of the views to be created. The knob lets you define the location and orientation of the views to be created, using the blue manipulators, top, bottom, left, right or rotated according to a given snapping, or according to a specified rotation angle. Click on the drawing sheet or at the center of the blue knob to generate the views. A progress bar appears temporarily, showing the view creation progress. The front, top and left views of the selected sub-assembly are created. You may need to move the views to position improperly on the drawing. To do this, simply drag the front view, the active view with the red frame, with the cursor, and drop it when you are satisfied with the position of the views. Creating a section view. This task will show you how to create a section view using a view you previously generated. Section views make drawings more readable by replacing the hidden elements of parts, including holes, with filled areas. Double-click the view from which you want to create the section view to activate it. In this particular case, double-click the top view. In the drawing window, click Offset Section View in the Views toolbar. Select the axis line in the top view. Note that selecting this axis line makes the view callout associative by default to the corresponding 3D feature. The first point of the cutting profile is automatically created on the view. The section plane appears and moves dynamically on the 3D subassembly while you define the profile on the drawing. Double-click the last point of the cutting profile to end its creation. The section plane automatically disappears, and a preview is displayed. Define the section view position using the cursor. Positioning the view also defines the section view direction, as if it were a left or a right projection view. The direction of the callout blue arrows changes as you change the cursor position. Click to generate the view. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. Overloading element properties. This task will show you how to overload the properties of elements in the section view you created previously. Right-click the section view AA. Select section view AA object. Overload properties. The characteristics dialog box is displayed. Select the elements that you want to edit, in this case, the slow speed shaft and the two bearings as shown. These elements are highlighted as you select them in the drawing and listed in the dialog box. In the dialog box, select slow speed shaft as the first element to edit and click the edit button. The edited dialog box is displayed. Uncheck cut in section views to specify that the 3D element should not be cut in the section view. Click OK to validate and exit the dialog box. Back in the characteristics dialog box, select the two bearings elements to edit them simultaneously, and click the edit button. In the edited dialog box, choose another color in the appropriate box of the graphic properties area. Click OK to validate and exit the dialog box. In the characteristics dialog box, you can notice that the listed characteristics have been updated for each element. Click OK again. A dialog box is displayed while the view is being recomputed. The selected elements are updated in the view, the slow speed shaft is not cut anymore, and the bearings are displayed with a different color. Generating balloons and a bill of material. This task will show you how to insert the advanced bill of material. Insert a bill of material. Generate balloons. The top view, in which you will generate the balloons and the bill of material, should still be active from the previous task. If not, double-click it to activate it. Inserting advanced bill of material. Select insert. Generation. Bill of material. Advanced bill of material. Click in the drawing sheet to specify where the bill of material should be inserted. In this particular case, click at the bottom right of the top view. The bill of material is created. This advanced bill of material can be customized to display the required columns apart from the default columns. Inserting a bill of material. Select Insert. Generation. Bill of material. Bill of material. Click in the drawing sheet to specify where the bill of material should be inserted. In this particular case, click at the bottom right of the top view. The bill of material is created. The bill of material provides information on the product element from which the view was generated. Generating balloon. Note that the assembly components have previously been numbered in the product structure workbench using the generate numbering command. Click Generate Balloons in the Generation toolbar. The balloons are automatically generated onto the active view. You can reposition them if you like. Balloons correspond to references defined on the different components of an assembly. Creating an isometric view and changing its properties. This task will show you how to create an isometric view, change the view properties. Creating an isometric view. Click the isometric view in the Views toolbar. Now, in the assembly window, click on the desired plane on the 3D assembly to define the reference plane. A green frame with the preview of the isometric view to be created, as well as blue manipulators, appear. These manipulators let you redefine the reference plane orientation of the view. Click to generate the view. A progress bar appears while the view is being created. Optionally drag the view to position it as wanted on the drawing. Changing the view properties. Right-click the isometric view and select Properties. On the View tab, check 3D colors in the dress-up area. In the Generation Mode area, select Raster from the View Generation Mode drop-down list. Click the Options button. The Generation Mode Options dialog box is displayed. Select Shading with Edges from the Mode drop-down list. Click Close to exit the dialog box. Back in the Properties dialog box, click OK to validate. A progress bar appears while your modifications are being taken into account. The view is now in raster mode, displaying shading with edges. You can position the views for better results. You have reached the end of the second section of this tutorial and you have learned about assembly drawings. You may go to the first section of this tutorial and learn about part drawings if you have not already done so.